What's up, everybody? This is Scratch. I got a quick video here for you. Today, we're going to take a look at streaming directly to Twitch from your Xbox console natively. This update just came out today to everybody. There are some features that were in it last week or that came up new last week that I planned on doing a video on. But now that everything is out, I'm just going to do them all together. So if you see something in here that's not there that you don't have, it could still be in preview, but to my knowledge, everything is out now and the whole thing went live today. That being said, I do have chapters, so if you want to skip around and you don't care about all this or you already know some of this, feel free to check those out and do that. I'm doing it in all the latest videos that we have. But in the interest of not rambling and hopefully you just watch it and don't use those, let's just jump over to the console and we'll take a look at how this works. Okay, so here we are on the Xbox dashboard. Now, to get to the streaming section, it's the same place where your captures are. So we're gonna press the guide button and then you're gonna go over to this little box with the arrow sticking out of it. That could be anywhere because again, you can customize where this goes. I have videos about that. But wherever that is, find the capture and share tab. And then you're gonna come down here to where it says live streaming. Click on that. Now, when we get here, it says go live now. However, that's because I've already linked my Twitch account to my Xbox, and you can do that right from here. If it's not linked, it'll bring up a QR code or a code, and you've got to go to twitch.tv/activate or something along those lines and put in the code or scan the QR code. So you're gonna need a phone or a tablet or some other way to get on the internet through your PC, however it goes. And then you can just put the codes in, you can link it. You can also share this on your profile, which I have a link above in the cards up here at the top. If you want to check those out, you can link all your social profiles. That was an update last February for about a year now. But if you don't have it turned on, I'll show you. You can check that out. But anyways, yeah, we're going to get started. This will be basically just your stream setup. So to start with a stream setup, you just have your stream name. Obviously, you just click on it and you just fill it out. That's pretty straightforward. And then you can turn your microphone on or off. So the microphone that it's using is actually the microphone in my headset here. So I'm gonna leave that turned on. And then I'm gonna come down here to manage my webcam. And I'm gonna turn the camera on. And then I'm gonna move the camera position to wherever I wanna have it show up on the screen in the overlay for my stream. So for example, you can go to the corners or the bottom middle or however you wanna do it. And it's basically going to use your webcam. You can use, I have a list of webcams down below that you can use. I have a Logitech Brio 4K, so that's not working for whatever reason, but it does allow me, it sees it as a camera, but it doesn't ever load the preview. So I don't know what's that about, but I don't think it's compatible, but it's compatible enough that I can show it to you. But like a C922, Logitech C922 or whatever, I have a link down below that lists all the compatible cameras. If you don't have one or you want to get one, they're relatively inexpensive. You can probably get them off Amazon for like $50 or less maybe, and they should work for you. So you can put your camera anywhere on the screen if you want, or you can just turn it off altogether and you don't have to have it. Next up, we have audio options and other options. Now, because I have a microphone turned on, the party audio can be on or off here as well. If I have microphone turned off, you'll see that they're grayed out and I can't do nothing with them. So if you run into that trouble, that's why. You got to turn the microphone on. Anyways, moving on. So now you can adjust the game volume versus your voice volume. So you're going to want to play with this because it's going to kind of depend on like what sort of a headset you have, how it's connected, how good it is, how bad it is, whatever. That's going to kind of change depending on the quality of the microphone that you're using. And then so you may want to turn yourself up or down or whatever. And then the same with the party audio, make sure they're heard over the game and that sort of thing. So just kind of play around with those sliders until you get, you know, find your sweet spot for your specific setup. Next, we have change the resolution and the bit rate. So if you have high enough upload speed on your internet, you could stream at 1080p and upload at 6,000 kilobits per second. Or go all the way down to 360, 500 if you have, like, unfortunately have bad internet. Sorry to say, if you have to do that. But keep grinding, keep streaming no matter what your upload speed is. Anyways, next we have an overlay. Now this is what's been in the update. We can move this overlay around anywhere we want. And you'll notice that the expanded version shows that I'm recording, how long I've been recording, how many people are watching, and it says that I'm using a mic and a camera. If I go to compact, it just tells me I have the mic and the camera, and you can see that it's recording, but it doesn't show too many things. The update from last week was the transparency. Now you can use this transparency to almost make that probably almost invisible. I'll move it up here so you can see it above my head probably, yep. But you can see how you can kind of play with the transparency. So if you don't want that bar sitting there, but you want to be able to kind of reference it, you can thin it out a little bit, or you just don't have to display the full size one at all if you don't want to. So that's pretty much it in a nutshell. Oh yeah, don't forget to turn your party on or off if you want to do that. So thank you all for watching. I definitely appreciate you checking the video out and the support and the comments and the likes and all that stuff. It's definitely appreciated. It's super helpful to the channel. So thank you for continuing to do that. I look at my analytics just about every day and they continue to amaze me. And that's all thanks to all of you who are here checking these things out. So I definitely appreciate it. We'll have some more videos coming out. There's some new updates that are going to be coming. So we'll have them here. So make sure you check it out. And I'll catch y'all next time. Thanks for watching.